Hello everyone. In this video tutorial, we'll see how to program alkaline phosphatase kit on any semi-automated biochemistry analyzer. Please note that in this video, we are using the kit manufactured by Anamol Laboratories Private Limited. Whatever information is required to program the software has been mentioned in the instructions for use by the manufacturer. Using this information, you can program any semi-automated biochemistry analyzer. Let's see how we can do it. The first thing that we need to do is switch on the instrument and come to the main menu. Once we are at the main menu, select Test Operations and then select Add New Test. Here multiple options are available in which we have to select Kinetic because alkaline phosphatase is a kinetic parameter. As you can see, you have to enter multiple information over here. The first information that needs to be entered is the name of the test. Here you can enter any name which is suitable according to your laboratory settings. In this video, we are entering ALP as the name of the test. Once you have entered the name, select Enter and come back to the home screen. The next information that needs to be entered is primary wavelength. Now the information about primary wavelength can be seen in the instructions for use, where the manufacturer clearly mentions at what wavelength the absorbance needs to be taken. To enter this information in the software, select the option of primary wavelength and then select filter 1. And from the list, choose the wavelength that is mentioned in the instructions for use. Now, because the manufacturer has not given any information about secondary wavelength or filter number 2, we will leave this option blank. Press Escape to come back to the home screen. The next information that needs to be added is of temperature or flow cell temperature. Again, this information can be seen in the instructions for use, where the manufacturer clearly mentions at what temperature the absorbance needs to be taken. Now, because in this case, the default temperature mentioned is 37 degrees Celsius, we do not have to change it. The next information that needs to be added is of KF or kinetic factor, which is to be maintained at 1.0. The next information that is to be added is of volume or aspiration volume. Now, aspiration volume can be maintained at 500 microliters, or else if you are doing the entire test in 500 microliters, then the aspiration volume can be reduced to 400 microliters. The next information that needs to be added is of unit. To check what unit you have to enter into the software, refer to the linearity column in the instructions for use. Whatever unit is mentioned in the linearity, same unit we have to enter into the software. To do this, select the option of unit and from the list, choose the unit that is mentioned in the instructions for use. The next information that needs to be added is lag time or delay time and read time. Again, this information can be seen in the instructions for use, where the manufacturer mentions what is the delay time or lag time and what is the read time. To enter this value in the software, select the option of lag time and again select the option of lag time and enter the numerical value that is seen in the instructions for use and press enter. Again, select the option of read time and enter the numerical value that is seen in the instructions for use and press enter and escape to come back to the home screen. Again, the next information that needs to be entered is of blank settings, whether reagent or distilled water is to be used for blanking. This information can also be seen in the instructions for use, where the manufacturer clearly mentions whether reagent or distilled water is to be used for blanking. In this case, because reagent is to be used for blanking, we will select the option of blank and then select option yes. The next information that needs to be added is of QC. If you are running any quality control sera, the value of normal and abnormal range can be entered over here. The next information that is to be entered is of normal value in the patient sample. Now the laboratory has to establish its own normal value, but if the laboratory has not established its normal value, then you can refer to the normal value mentioned in the instructions for use by the manufacturer. From this, you have to enter the lowest and the highest range in the software. To do this, select the option of normal range and then select option yes. and first select option low and enter the lowest range that is seen in the instructions for use. Press enter and then select option high and enter the highest range that is seen in the instructions for use. And press enter and escape to come back to the home screen. The next information that needs to be added is of standard, whether the standard is available in the kit or not. Again, this information can be seen in the instructions for use, where the manufacturer clearly mentions whether the standard is available in the kit or not. In this case, the standard is not available in the kit. Hence, in the software, we will keep the option of standard as no. The next information that needs to be added is of factor. Again, this information can be seen in the instructions for use, where the manufacturer clearly mentions what is the factor used for the calculation of the result. To enter this value in the software, select the option of factor and enter the numerical value that is seen in the instructions for use. And press enter. The next information that is to be added is of limit setting. In this, three information needs to be added. First is of initial OD, second is of maximum delta absorbance per minute, and the third one is reagent linearity. In the first option of initial OD, refer to the instructions for use, where the manufacturer clearly mentions in the column of blank absorbance limit what is the minimum absorbance that needs to come to validate the test. Enter the same information in the instructions for use. And press enter. The second option of maximum delta absorbance per minute can be left blank. The third information of reagent linearity can also be seen in the instructions for use, where the manufacturer clearly mentions what is the linearity of the kit. To enter this value in the software, select the option of reagent linearity and enter the numerical value that is seen in the instructions for use. And then press enter and escape to come back to the home screen. Now, as you can see, whatever information is required to program the software has been added. To save the program, select the option Save. Now our program has been saved in the software. To view the program, go to List Test and then go to the window where our program has been saved. In this video, our program has been saved in position number 76. To open the program, select it. If you wish to run any patient sample, select the option Run, and further the instrument will guide you how to take the absorbance. Thank you, and we hope this video has been helpful for you.